I'd say most of it. And at camp, we all, myself included, we all get right with God. We rededicate our life. Boy, we're there for 4 or 5 days. You can go ahead, brother. And, man, we're ready to tire the world up. We'll charge hell with a water pistol, you know, when we come home. Then, you know, when you get home, it's not always that easy because the old friends is waiting, and they're wanting to go here, and they're wanting to go there. So we'd like to just illustrate that. That's good. Give me that one right there on that chair. Illustrate that for you tonight and just show it to you, okay?
All right.
Lord, today I'm going to spend the whole day with you. I'm going to read my Bible and I'm going to pray and try to get close to you, because this summer I've just been doing whatever I want really, and I hadn't really got to spend a whole lot of time with you. So today, before I go back to school next week, I'm going to just spend my whole day with you and try to get close to you again. Come in.
Hey, Sabrina, what's up?
Hey, Shelly.
What are you doing?
I'm reading my Bible and just trying to spend some time with the Lord.
Well, you should go shopping with me today.
Oh, I'd love to.
But you can pay later.
I've been putting it off, and I really need to spend some time with the Lord today.
Well, just call me if you want to go.
Okay, thanks.
Bye.
Bye. Come in.
Hey.
Hey, Jordan. What's up?
Nothing. I'm going to a party tonight. You should come.
I can't. I've already told the Lord that I'd spend the day with him.
It's the last big party before school starts.
I know, but I really need to stay here and just spend time with the Lord today.
All right. Well, if you change your mind, let me know.
Okay. Thanks for inviting me. Come in.
Hey, it's me again.
Hey, y'all.
So instead of going shopping, we should go to this awesome party. It's going to be like the best one before school starts.
I don't know. I've already promised the Lord, and I've really been putting it off a lot.
That really cute guy you like is going to be there, and he's been asking about you.
Are you serious?
Yep.
Michael? Aw.
Come on. It's going to be fun.
Come on. I don't know. He was asking about me. I've liked him since second grade.
I know. And school's starting back.
That would be so cool if we were like dating when we started school back.
Yeah.
Okay, you guys go on out and I'll be out in just a minute, okay?
All right.
Lord, I know I just told you that I was going to spend the day with you, and I will when I come back, but I'm going to go to this party, and I'm going to meet up with this guy that I've liked for a long time, and I'll come back and spend time with you then, okay? And I'll read my Bible and pray then, okay? Lord, listen. This party, there might have some worldly music or something, and there might be some people drinking. I don't know what they're going to be doing, but I'm not going to be doing any of it. But I know that you'll feel uncomfortable. So you stay here, and I'll be back in just a little bit, I promise. And then I'll spend some time with you, okay? Lord, listen, I know that you told me that you'd never forsake me or leave me. But if you will, please just stay here and leave me alone for just a little bit, and I'll go to this party, and I promise I'll be right back to you, okay? You just stay here. Lord, I really, really hate to do this to you, but... Stay right here. Lord, I'm so sorry.
I didn't realize that every time I fail you and make broken promises that I let you down and now you do the cross again. God, I'm so sorry. Please forgive me.
They tell me Jesus died for my transgressions and that he paid the price a long, long time ago when he gave his life for me on a hill called Calvary. But there's something else I really want to know. Does he still feel the nails every time I fail? Does he hear the crowd cry, crucify again? Am I causing him pain? Then I know I've got to
change. Does he still feel those nails?
Cause I just can't bear the thought.
How's your life?
Hurting him.
Think about it this evening, young people. Listen to him.
It seems that I'm so good at breaking promises.
Isn't that true?
And I treat his precious grace so careless.
Woo! Yes!
But each time that he forgives.
Yes, amen.
What if he relives?
Amen.
The agony he felt on. Does he still feel the nails every time I fail? Does he hear the crowd cry, crucify again?
You going to stand for him at school this year? You just going to blend in with everybody else? Are you willing to stand up for Jesus and not be ashamed of
him? I've got to change.
You'll be glad you did one day.
I just can't.
Any little sissy can do what everybody else doing.
Of hurting.
Be a young man, a young lady with some courage. Saints, amen.
It seems that I'm so good at breaking
the way we are.
Promises.
And
I treat his precious grace so carelessly. But each time that he forgives, what if he relives the agony he felt on that tree? Does he still feel the nails every time I fail? Does he hear the crowd cry, crucify? I just can't bear the thought of hurting him. Cause I just can't bear the thought of hurting him.
Amen. 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 Now I want you to look at that, young people, and I want you to think of your life, and I'll think of mine. And I want you to realize that every time we as Christians deliberately go against the Lord, that's good. We'll build him right there, brother. Crucify the Son of God afresh and bring him to an open shame. And you remember the Lord said, I'll go with you and I'll never leave you nor forsake you. He goes with you to school. He sits right beside you. Actually, he's in you. And we need to keep that in mind. What I'm going to do for just a few minutes, actually, I changed the what I was going to preach a little bit from when I first announced it a few weeks ago. And I want you to take your Bible just for a few minutes before we go. And I want to show you something. John chapter 15. John chapter 15. It seems that young people are in great danger tonight. The most dangerous place in the world for a young person to be, believe this or not, is in their mother's womb. Oh, 50 million abortions in this country since it was made legal. If you got out of your mother's womb alive, you ought to thank God for it. Your mother didn't abort you. A man asked me one time, somebody was arguing about it, and they said, but we're not sure that that unborn fetus is a child. I said, I'm sure. And they said, well, how are you sure? I said, you know, when Elizabeth was pregnant and Mary was pregnant, you know what the Holy Ghost said? It said they were great with child. Great with child. Settles it. As far as I'm concerned, it don't matter whatever doctor and scientist in the world says. The Holy Ghost said that was a child inside them. And if you kill a child, you're guilty of murder. I didn't write it. The Holy Ghost said it's a child. If you say it's not a child, you're wrong. The Holy Ghost is right. So if you get out of your mother's womb alive, the next place you go is in the home. The home has become a place of danger. We all just heard of one not far from here. It's a few month old baby being abused. They say that, I forgot the statistics, so many in 10 children will have some kind of child abuse in their life or home, relative or somebody in their life. Probably 10 or 15 here tonight have been or are being abused. If you make it out of that home for a few years, then you go to school. The schools are waiting on you. Thank God there's a lot of good Christian teachers and principals and witnesses and there's support and help at school. Thank the Lord for it. But there's also an evil element waiting on you, boys and girls. There's some people that would lead you the wrong way. There's some people that get you in trouble. There's some people that get you on drugs. There's some people that get you on... I'll never forget, I was about third grade. I was riding the school bus home, and I remember these boys cussing. They were using four-letter words. I didn't know what they meant. And I remember that as a young child, it had an effect on me. And growing up, every dirty, rotten, low-down thing I ever learned, I learned it from somebody that was my friend at school, or I went home to spend the night with, or gone to a ball game, or somewhere like that. Mom and Daddy, amen? Almost every bad thing you ever learn, you learn from older kids at school. So it can be a very dangerous place. Now, what I want to talk about tonight is how this world feels about your Savior. Look at John chapter number 15. And I want you to notice a statement that Jesus made here. And the statement is verse 18. If the world hates you, Jesus said, John 15, 18, you know that it hated me before it hated you. The Lord said, the world hated him. The Lord said, the world hates him. Now what I want to do tonight is show you that this world, I really hate to do what I'm getting ready to do. I don't get any pleasure out of this. Honestly, it grieved my stomach to show you some of the clips off TV that I'm going to show you tonight. Nevertheless, you know and going to have to know that the world hates our Savior. Now, I'm going to show you the real bad stuff. The rock singer, the rappers, all the wickedness that's going on and blaspheming his name. I've got many, many rock albums and records where they curse his name, where they call God every name in the book. I can just give you a little bit example tonight, just a very, very little, very, very little. And I'll give you a few. Listen to these bumper stickers. These are bumper stickers actually out on cars. Quote, drive carefully, there's no heaven. Quote, I've read the Bible, that's why I'm an atheist. Third, worship me, or I'll torture you forever. Have a nice day, God. Atheist calls, I don't believe in fairy tales. Quote, not smart enough for science? Try religion. Quote, for God so loved the world that he sent Darwin to explain it. Quote, God hates facts. Quote, T-shirt, science flies people to the moon. Religion flies people into buildings. And so the world tonight has a distorted, twisted view of God. You're going to see some people here tonight who don't understand God and try to explain God with their own natural mind, and it can't be done. The Bible said the natural man receiveth not the things of God, for they are spiritually discerned. Neither can he know them. You can't know them unless you're spiritual. You can't understand the Bible. You got people out there trying to explain the Bible that ain't even saved. And they have no understanding of the Word of God till you get born again. Lost person can't understand the Bible, much less teach it or explain it. That's why you have so many religion courses in colleges and stuff where they get everybody confused. They don't even know what you're talking about. So tonight, I'm fixing to show you that the world still hates Jesus. And when I get sound and picture here, you can turn it the rest of the way down. You don't believe we're in the last days? Take a look, folks. Just take a look. Look at these advertisements. All right. There's your verse of scripture. John 15:18. Get them all up. There you go. Look at here. Watch this tonight.
Then get ready for the ultimate historical revenge fantasy. Yes, he's back. Jesus Uncrossed.
The name of this movie is Jesus Uncrossed. And he said, I'm off the cross now. I'm coming back at you. And I'm mad. Watch him.
He's risen from the dead.
Did you miss me?
And he's preaching anything but forgiveness. He may be wearing sandals, but...
Watch it tonight.
Silent. With Brad Pitt as St. Peter.
I need me, 11 apostles. We're going to be doing one thing.
Reigns as Pontius Pilate.
Jesus.
Lawson as Judas Iscariot.
Jesus, chill, man, chill.
When you get to heaven, say hi to my dad.
Jesus blows a hole through Judas with a shotgun and said, when you get to heaven, say hey to my dad. That's twisted, perverted of the scriptures of the Word of God. And that is to blaspheme him so you kids will think the Bible's some kind of joke. Now watch it tonight. Watch it.
Less violent Passion of the Christ.
They're saying it's less violent than the Passion of Christ. Ha ha ha. Never make a joke out of it.
Jesus used the N-word. Jesus Uncrossed.
No more Mr. Nice Jesus.
Ain't that something? Watch this. Cartoon, The Family Guy. Watch them as they mock God.
Hey, God said, let the earth bring forth the living creatures and...
Bible fight!
Hey, Lois, there's a Bible in here. Hey, look at me. I'm a Christian. I'm reading the Bible.
You don't want to get involved with Emerald...
Hey, try that with a book of the Koran and see what happens. Let somebody get on cartoons and get the Koran out and mock it and like and tear it out and burn it and watch. We'll have war right here in the United States. But God's people sat back. God's people said, well, it's the freedom of speech. God's people just goes to sleep while the devil is cheating a generation of young people on what it's really like to know the real Jesus.
Groups, they believe in all kinds of weird stuff.
If I believe in Jesus hard enough, I will not die.
If I believe in Snake Jesus hard enough, he will die.
If I believe in Tree Jesus hard enough, both of them will die.
Yay! Thank you, Tree Jesus!
Year 33 AD.
The Messiah! He's gone!
Where did he go?
Hang on!
They cannot resist the temptation to bring him down and make him some street hood smoking pot and blowing up stuff.
Man, you crazy, Jesus! You crazy!
That's what my ex-wife said.
Son of God!
Chris Tucker and Jim Cavito crucify this.
You know how to use one of these?
You know how to use one of these?
This July, let he who is without sin kick the first.
To be here.
So, Jesus, what have you been doing since you've been back?
Oh, see, the return of Jesus, they always make him look like some kind of anemic, weak, sissified, somebody that's about half out of their mind, can't open their eyes, about half lit with drugs, and Jay Leno's is interviewing him.
Oh, just kind of bumming around, playing a little Call of Duty 4, eating a lot of Pinkberry.
Oh, yeah, right, of course, yeah, Pinkberry,
Add up. You friends with Gary, who owns the dry cleaners?
No.
Are you Jesus Christ?
No.
Oh, my God, you are...
No, I'm not. I'm just a guy working at a record store.
Huh. Well, if you're not Jesus Christ, then you won't mind if I... Jesus!
Yes, I am.
Oh, my God! The Messiah! You've returned! You've returned to bring us the good word!
What word?
Now, what's here, the Lord? Here they got Jesus... doing a little dance, giving you the 666 sign. That don't mean three-pointer, kids. That's a national signal of 666, of the Illuminati, of secret groups who seek to seduce in athletes and movie stars into them. I got a whole nother message on that. We'll do it some other time. But don't you look at that. Watch it now. What's the 666 sign? Is that something?
Yes.
Now they put him in Hollywood and make a joke out of him. A little song, Family Guy, Me and Jesus.
Come and hug and squeeze us, 'cause you know that he's a simply Christ-terrific dude.
Look at that. See all the dancing Las Vegas girls at the foot of the cross! Listen, people. If I'd have showed something like that in a church 50 years ago, they'd have been lawsuits all over the country the next day. People wouldn't have slept a wink that night. You know what's wrong with us? We've been desensitized. What's killing our churches tonight is not apostasy. We still believe right. It's apathy. And apathy means we just don't care. Long as we got food in our belly, long as we got money in the bank, long as we got a nice car, we couldn't care less if the whole world goes to hell. Watch it tonight.
His eyes are bluish. Bright
my boy.
Yes?
You're sweet as chocolate cake.
You bring me joy. And so I won't forsake you.
Notice everybody in there is a male. There's a lot more there than you just see. Male cheerleaders, male laying on the beach together, him and Jesus.
Like the gays do Jesus.
What a happy pair. Together we're hotter than walking on water. We walk on air.
You're a real pal, Jesus.
Well, I'll tell you this, Peter. You ain't never had a friend like me.
Me.
That please us.
'Cause we're close as Jesus.
Something wrong with that, buddy. It's blasphemy.
And Ramona Quimby are.
My life is sweeter with my new friend Peter.
You're a lotus.
See him throwing them strawberries
at?
Here's a man that wrote Family Guy. He is an atheist. He's been interviewed by one of the most dangerous men in America. This man on the left is one of the most dangerous men in this country. He's on a crusade against the Word of God.
Yes, I am. Yeah. Now, what do you think of the fact that it seems to be a movement that's gaining credibility as of late?
I think it's a...
People do seem to be coming out of the closet about that in a way they...
Jesus and you'll be fine, you know, 9/11 and Jesus. And I think they're finally starting to come out of that and realizing, wait a minute, maybe if he's wrong about this, maybe this is in fact fundamentally wrong. I think there's still a long way.
Watch this. Robot Chicken blasphemes the Lord Jesus Christ.
Hey, turn the blind up.
That's Jesus.
I can do this all day.
That's Jesus. He's beaten there, trying to talk.
You just give me a second before you... Okay, look, Gilmore Girls starts about that. Okay, look, could you seriously stop it?
Notice the one-eyed demon that I preach so much about. You know, the Antichrist has a bad right eye. One-eyed. There's that one eye. There's that one eye on your dollar bill. There's that one eye on all the rock singers. There's that covering of the right eye, the dark eye. Watch it tonight.
You just give me a second before you... Okay, look, Gilmore Girls starts about that. Okay, look, could you seriously stop it?
Who inspires them to write stuff like that? Where does that come from? Why is it... Why, if it ain't true, why keep bringing it up on TV every night? Let me tell you something tonight, boys and girls. There is a spirit out there. It's waiting on you as soon as you get out of here. It's trying to get your mind. It's trying to get your soul. It's trying to get your body. They'll wreck your life. The world don't care about you. I mean, let them go out there and take you to this party. Get your own drugs. You know what drugs does? It opens up your spirit to demonic powers and demon spirits. And I'm going to tell you tonight, you better keep your heart with all diligence. Guard yourself in the Word of God. Do like Rick said up here a while ago. Make up your mind. I don't care if they call me a nerd. I don't care if they make fun of me. I'll stand for Jesus and let this world go by. You listening? Watch it tonight. Watch this. What they're going to say.
Do you know who my dad is?
Do you know who my dad is?
Let he who is without sin cast the first stone.
Watch.
Blammo!
Jesus did it. Jesus did it. See, you don't realize. These are wicked cartoons showing Jesus fighting the devil. And the one eye there, see? See the one eye? The dark right eye? You think that's an accident? You know in Zechariah chapter 11, the Antichrist has the dark right eye? Watch it tonight, young people. There's somebody behind that. There's somebody after your soul. Watch the Simpsons here. They got a manger scene. There's the shepherd and Mary and Joseph and the baby Jesus laying in the crib. Somebody goes over it and the little Simpson guy goes up there and shoots it and shoots like he's shooting down in the crib saying, die, die, die. Watch it. Watch it again.
Die, die, die.
Watch it.
Die, die, die.
Think that's an accident? You think the world don't hate him? Watch it tonight. You think the world don't hate Jesus? They have the devil defeating him? They always show him as an anemic? I asked a girl out on bus route one day. I said, if Jesus and the devil, we was up here at trailer park on bus route, and these kids walking up there, this girl's about 15, two or three of them, and I said, if Jesus and the devil got in a fight, who would win? And she shrugged her shoulder and said, I don't know, the devil? And you know where they get that? They're taught all their life that Jesus is a weak, anemic, sissy sort of a person, and the devil's this big, strong person with muscles. All their life. They're programmed. Boys and girls, you ought to thank God that you're in a Bible-believing church where your eyes are being opened to what the King James Bible says about events and the future. Notice the all seeing eye on the popular clothing line at the mall. See that? I was on the Apostle shirts. That all seeing eye, the pyramid. That's the sign of the one eye and the Illuminati and the one world government. We won't take time to go into it. There's the one that's on your dollar bill. Over and over and over. The Bible said the love of money is the root of all evil. Look at Katy Perry, put that dark right eye. There's Aleister Crowley. And these girls, Keisha and Lady Doodoo, and every one of them, they're all of them's out there trying to blaspheme God and blaspheme the things of God with a 666 on their jacket. The 666 sign, the pyramid sign, or the sign of the Illuminati, the one eye, the monster, the demon that's coming, the Antichrist that's coming on this world to take over. And the Bible said he causeth all, both small and great, to have a mark on the right hand or the forehead. See the sign there? That's the eye of Horus. You can check that out on the internet instead of wasting your time on there if you got to have it. That's that eye of Horus with a 666 sign. It's a satanic symbol. Watch it tonight. Even the monster drink sign representing the 666. Look at that. The movie stars crucified on our buildings and billboards and just any way that can show the world their hatred for the Lord Jesus Christ. Notice the goat's head. Notice the owl on Justin Bieber's arm. The owl. Most of you don't have no idea what the owl represents in the Bible. The owl represents an unclean spirit. They represent demonic spirit. And those people up there in Nome, Alaska, where all those UFO abductions took place, they had FBI, they had psychiatrists interview those people, and every one of them, before it happened, said they saw this big, giant, white owl in their window before it took place. That's why owls are so popular in jewelry and necklaces and earrings. Check out what your Bible says about it. That's not an accident. Look at that. An owl with a dark right eye? They don't even know it's in the Bible. Somebody is leading them. Somebody is getting them ready. Somebody is preparing the world to worship the beast. But I got good news for you, boys and girls. Before that takes place, we're going to hear a trumpet. And if we're saved, thank God we're going to leave. We'll leave this world with a shout. Hallelujah. We'll get out of here and be home to be with the Lord. Amen. I hope you're ready. I hope you're saved. We're seeing the sign. Watch it tonight. Look at that. There's the owl. 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 There's the owl on your dollar bills. Look at this tonight. Out in Oklahoma, they are going to reveal a satanic statue. This is on the news. They can't keep it quiet. For design for the Baphomet. That's the goat's head. This is what Satan would really look like if you saw him without his masquerade. That goat's head with the horns. And look at how it pops up. This is the devil. The satanic. Look at that. Pentagram, five-pointed star. There's the goat's head with a horn. And look at these little boys sitting at his feet admiring him. And then look at his sign there. That's just like Pope gives on that right hand.
A group has unveiled designs for a 7-foot-tall statue of Satan that it wants at the Oklahoma State Capitol. The New York-based Satanic Temple says if Oklahoma can put a Ten Commandments statue on the Capitol grounds, they should be able to put their statue on the grounds as well. KOCO's Rob Hughes is live at the State House to show us what this statue looks like. Good morning, Rob.
Katie, good morning. And that statue they want put right next to the Ten Commandments here at the State Capitol. And I want to show you what this is going to look like. Take a look here. It's a 7-foot-tall, goat-headed demon sitting on a throne with two children next to it. The group Satanic Temple.
You think that ain't? You think they're not after our children, folks? Do you think their goal is not to reach every boy and girl? They have soul winners out. They put out literature. They're controlling the music industry that our kids love listening. Y'all know why rock music and rap music sounds so good? Because the dirty part of you likes that. Your flesh.
Since it's formally submitted its application and they are moving forward with plans, even though the state commission's put a moratorium on new requests. The commission says it wants to wait until...
Shirts, t-shirts. Look at that. Look at the name of that group. He's, oh man, that's cool. It ain't gonna be cool when they wind up there. It ain't gonna be cool 5 seconds when you wake up in hell. It ain't gonna be cool then. Watch it tonight, kids. You know what they're doing? They are teaching. And we ain't got time to get into this tonight. Some of you Bible scholars know what I'm talking about. Genesis chapter 6 said the sons of God saw the daughters of men that they were fair. There was something going on between fallen angels, satanic creatures, and girls. And that's why all these movies like Twilight and vampires and stuff, it's always the girl falling in love with the devil. And brother, there's something wrong. There's something wrong that Lady Gaga sings about, or Katy Perry and them sings about it. E.T., her boyfriend's extraterrestrial. It's a supernatural love. That's no accident. Jesus said, as it was in the days of Noah, so shall it be in the days of coming of the Son of Man. It's the same thing happening today. Girls fall in love with demonic creatures that don't die. They're devils. See that? It's the devil. Beauty and the Beast. Miley Cyrus, bed with an animal. Teaching our kids.
And fame has become really convoluted and, you know, kind of bad.
Listen to this girl.
If your ultimate goal is to be famous, then you're going to do a lot to get there, like sign your name in blood in a contract with the devil. Like, that's just the truth. I've seen so many people like forsake their moral code and their value systems just for a little bit of fame, and it's not worth it at the end of the day. It's really not worth it.
Thank God there's an honest one for a change. I praise God she told it right. She said it's not worth it at the end of the day. Girls, it's not worth it to sell out to that boy and do what's wrong just so he'll like you. Boys, it's not worth it to sell out to that crowd and drink or smoke dope with them just so they'll accept you in the group. It's not worth it. Life is too short. It's going to be over. Take your stand. You know what 2014 needs? You know what them schools and George Hildebrand and Freedom and over here at Burke Middle School and all them need? They need some young people that'll go say, I'm not talking about being a religious smart aleck. I'm just saying I'm going to live right. I'll read my Bible. I'm going to pray. I'm going to say no to the devil and let the Lord use you.
Come to me all the time.
I hate to even show you this, but I'm going to close with three little clips. And you think they don't hate Jesus? Listen to the world's version of the story of God sending His Son to be our Savior. And if you can watch this and understand it and not get mad, there's something wrong with you.
And then they say, Bill, I'm with you. I saw your movie. We're right here.
You know, I don't believe in that crazy biblical nonsense, just the central story. Oh, you mean the stupidest part? I mean, come on. God had a son. I mean, time out right there. God had a son? He's powerful beyond all imagination. He exists in a realm above time and space, but he has kids? What is this, Bonanza? He has a son. God had a son, and he said to him, Jesus, I'm sending you down to earth on a suicide mission.
Listen, that fool don't know. God does have a son, and he died for his sins. I can't hardly stand that. I can't hardly stand it. And there's something wrong with you if you think that's funny. There's something wrong with your heart, buddy, if you think that's funny. Listen, I'm all for having fun. I cut up, we like, but that ain't funny. God loved this world enough to let his son get beat to death on the cross for you. And it ain't no joke.
But don't worry, they can't kill you because you're really me. But it is going to hurt for a few days. I'm not going to lie about that, son. There's about 3 days you're going to hate me. But I'm doing this for you. I mean me. What am I saying? I'm me. You're me. You're you. But I go myself, but I have you. Me. What am I saying? Anyway. All right. Now. Now, Jesus, here's the plan. I, God the Father, wink, wink, I'll go down to earth first. You see, we'll split up the work because there's two of us.
Not really.
I'll go down to earth and I'll see if I can find a virgin Palestinian woman to impregnate so that she can give birth to you. I mean me. What am I saying? It's like Faye Dunaway in Chinatown. My sister, my daughter, my sister, my daughter. I mean, it is one of the silliest stories I've ever heard, but I don't mean to offend.
There's going to come a day when he won't think that's a silly story. There will come a day when that man will bow before a holy God and he'll say, Jesus is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. You'll do it now or you'll do it then. I got it over with. I bowed when I was 18 years old. Let me tell you something tonight. I ain't been the best Christian in the world. I've failed the Lord many a time. But my record is clear today. For he washed my sins away because the old account was settled long ago. Watch this.
A lot of people.
This woman here blasphemes the Lord continually. She stands on stage and accepts a reward. And she says, a lot of people stand up here and thank God for this award and Jesus. And she said, nobody had less to do with this than Jesus. And then she says, blank, Jesus, this is my God now. That's Hollywood.
Come up here and they thank Jesus for this award. I want you to know that no one had less to do with this award than Jesus. He didn't help me a bit.
You hear that? My Lord. And this young man takes lighter fluid, puts it on God's word, and illustrates my sermon tonight.
Then watch it burn. Jesus Christ, I hate you.
Yes, they can't learn how to burn a Bible.
Then watch it burn. Jesus Christ, I hate you.
And that's what I was preaching about tonight, young people. They still hate Jesus. God's speaking to your heart tonight.
Then get ready for the evil revenge fest.
What's that? Where you stand tonight with the Lord? Well, Jason's coming. I'm going to ask you something tonight. Which door have you entered in? Are you on the Lord's side or on the side of this world that crucified Him and nailed Him to a cross? It's going fast. You're going to be grown and out of school before you know it. Somebody put me down back there. Put me up. God speak in your heart. The Bible said, "It's such an hour as you think not. The Son of Man cometh." It's heaven or hell, young people. And all of your friends, all the teachers, and everybody you know, and everybody in your family is going to wind up in heaven or hell. There's only two places people can go when they die. Heaven or hell. Where are you headed tonight? Where are you headed tonight? Where are you headed tonight? I would leave this world not knowing where I was going when I left. I'd settle it tonight. There's a tale, there's a hell, there's a hell, there's a hell, there's a heaven, there's a hell. Jesus died for you so you wouldn't have to go to hell. Don't do it. Don't do it. Don't say, "Well, I want to be cool so the world will like me." It'll be over with real quick. Bible said there's only one way to go. There's only one way to go to heaven. That's by putting your faith and trust in the Lord Jesus Christ that died for your sins. Amen. Crystal, some of the girls come around here. I want y'all to sing in a minute. And I want y'all to look at these pictures tonight. There's what He done for you. Many, many years ago. Come on, some of you girls. I'm going to make us a group here. And I want them to sing, "I have been blessed." And we have been blessed. We have been blessed. We have been blessed. God's been good to us. If you don't know that you're saved, look what He did for you tonight. You know that Jesus that He was making fun of a minute ago? That's what Jesus did for that guy. And He did that for Madonna and Katy Perry and Britney Spears and Miley Cyrus. Jesus did that for everybody in Hollywood. I don't know about you tonight, but I'd want to be the first one in that altar. Yeah. Just come and say, "Lord, I ain't much, but I will live for You. By Your grace, I want to do right." If you're here tonight and you've not been saved, young person, don't leave this place. There's a lot of people here that can take the Bible and show you exactly what you got to do to get saved. Look how they beat those nails in His hands and through His feet. And He died so that you could be forgiven. Fall in love with Him tonight. Make up your mind that you're going to live for Him and Him only. And let God do a work in your heart, okay?
Yeah. Amen. Amen.
Let God speak to your heart. You come right now. Go ahead, y'all sing. One of you men, please come on. Let God. Come on. Let's obey the Lord tonight, young people. Come on. Come on. Just get out of your seat. Come on right now. Come on. Come on. Amen. Amen. Thank God. Thank God. Thank God. Amen. That's right. Come on. Let's move right now. Let's obey the Lord. Mamas and daddies. Come on right now. Let's go. Amen. Don't say no to Jesus. Come on, Lord. That's right. Help them sing, y'all. Right. Amen. Say it out now. Come on now. If you need somebody to pray with you, come on. Get out of your seat and come.
In the winter,
that's good. Amen.
Flowers in spring.
Let's obey the Lord tonight. Let's obey the Lord tonight. Come on. Come on. That's right. Mamas and daddies, teenagers, I'm going to stand for the Lord tomorrow at school. When I go to school, I'm going to do what's right. I'm going to do what's right. Amen.
Clothes on my back.
Woo!
Shoes on my back.
young people.
I have been.
Come on, boys. Come on, girls. Everybody say it now. Now, everybody.
I have been blessed. God's so good to me. Precious are His eyes.
Come on tonight. Come on tonight, kids. Amen. Come on, boys and girls. Amen. Come on now.
It's not even time, so I'll just thank Him for being so kind.
Come on, boys. Come on, girls. Let's get this older tonight. Say, Lord, I'm going to stand for You at school this year. That's right. Amen, big boy. That's right. Come on. Take a stand. Be a man for Jesus. Be a man for Jesus tonight. Come on. Be a young lady and take a stand. That's right, girls. Come on. Come on. Let's get in here tonight. Take that stand God wants us to take. That man. Hallelujah. Woo! Yeah.
Here's the kingly son. Isaac is
his. Amen. This man got saved tonight, y'all. Woo! Amen. God always does something like that. Amen.
I have been blessed. God's so good to me.
Ain't God been good to you tonight?
Hallelujah. Amen. No way I could care.
Come on tonight. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Let's go. Come on. Let's go.
So I'll just thank Him.
Come on, girls, come on. Get this older tonight. Come on, Lord. Yeah.
So good.
I've been blessed.
Been blessed.
Amen. Amen. Say it out now. Say it out now.
We live in a country.
Well, I'll thank God for excellent tonight. You need to come on tonight. Come on.
Where our place
yes,
hallelujah.
For freedom. Come on, kids. Come on, do what God wants you to do. Come on, come on. Let's go.
Obey the Lord. It's liberty call.
Amen. Amen.
Some gave it all so that we could be blessed.
Come on tonight, teenagers. Come on. Come on, young people. Let's go. Amen.
It's my shoulder to lean.
That's the Lord tonight. Thank God.
I am down.
Amen.
The rock where He leads.
Woo!
The calm of Your wind.
Amen.
The place where He hides me.
Amen.
Under His wing.
Come on, girl. Come on, right now.
It's
come on.
Just a song.
Amen.
He's the reason I sing.
Amen.
I have been blessed.
Everybody, let's sing it now. Together, everybody, say it with us now.
I have been blessed. God's so good to me. Precious are His thoughts of You and me.
Come on now.
Where I could count Him.
Not enough time.
It's not enough time. So I'll just thank Him for
being so.
My shoulder to lean on.
Amen.
When I am
done what you're supposed to do tonight,
let
everything fix. Come on down here and get it right.
When
come on.
I'm overwhelmed.
Amen.
The place where He hides me under His wings. He's not just a song.
He's the reason I sing.
could count them.
Yeah, closing up time. Praise in the night. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah.
So
high. That's all right. What a shout and praise in the night. God's been good to us. Everybody sing now.
I have been blessed. God's so good to me. Precious are His thoughts of you and me.
Amen.
The way I could count them, there's not enough time. So I'll just thank Him for me. God has been good, so good. I have been blessed.
Just stay up here, y'all. Just stay up here. Give me just a little bit more. A little bit more light on the choir part here, Ron. I tell you what I want us to do tonight. I want every one of you, every one of you, if you're going to school tomorrow, I want you to come up here with me and with the little ones out here in the front and all the rest of you up here, and we're going to pray with you. We're going to have a word of prayer with you. So come on, every one of you, on both sides of the choir, every one of you, if you're going to school tomorrow, get up here. Amen. Let's go. We're going to pray with you before you go to school tomorrow. I'll let you sing a verse of that song. Amen. Amen. Come on. You're supposed to be sitting up here anyway. Let's go. Anybody else going to school tomorrow? Amen. Anybody else going to school tomorrow? Get up here. Lord, have mercy on you. Look at that crowd. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Somebody get us a count there, y'all. Anybody else going to school? Amen. Come on, Jessica. You can make it. Amen. This is a girl that got hit by a car that night in Morgan and over there that when they sang that Friday night thing. And she comes here to church and the Lord just saved her right through that. Isn't that a blessing? Hallelujah. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. Somebody count them. Get me a count here while I'm talking. Somebody do that for me. One of you smart men. Smart ladies. Ladies, act like them $10 bills. Hurry. All right. There's a bunch back in there you can't see, but we're going to, how many of you tonight, did anybody up here tonight, you got saved, you just got saved tonight, would you raise your hand please, if you ask the Lord to save you tonight, there's one, two, three, four, there's four, five, then this young man back here, that's six, I think, isn't that a blessing, amen, there's you some good, juicy gossip to go spread around, go home and call all them people, put it on Nosebook. Woo! Shining light. Had six people saved tonight. Everybody will go, well, that's really good. I hate your guts. That's the shape Christians are in. That's the shape Christians are in nowadays. Well, hallelujah. How many you got, Eric? Amen. 70. I'm going to school tomorrow. That's like we fed the multitude this morning. You know, if you was here this morning, we fed 5,000 with a half a box of Kleenexes. If you wasn't here, you don't know what we're talking about. It's what you get for laying out. Amen. Let's sing a verse of that song, girls. Lead us. And that first verse in the chorus, just the first verse in the chorus. Everybody knows it. Ready? Here we go. Go ahead. First verse.
Same one?
Yeah.
When He moves among us,
that's what we need.
All that He does.
I hope you remember this.
All of His mercy.
When the devil tries to get you to go somewhere.
All of His love.
When they try to get you to go to a party. You just remember right here. You remember being in church. You remember, I'm going to do what God wants me to do. Make up your mind right now. Amen.
Would never contain.
Amen.
How I've been blessed.
All right, the chorus. Everybody.
God. The chorus, sing now.
I have been blessed. God so good to me.
Precious.
Precious are His thoughts of you and me.
No way
I could count them. There's not enough time. So I'll just thank Him for being so.
Stay right there. Ron, give us a little bit more light, please. Amen. Listen, y'all, you pray for these boys and girls. I don't know where all of them goes to school, but I know they need prayer. I know they need prayer. There you go. Bring them on up. Bring them on up so we can see them. Look at them. You know what? The devil would like to ruin every single one of them. And he got a plan for them too. Don't you doubt it. If he can't get mom and daddy to bust up and get a divorce, he'll start working on some other way. School, friends, stuff like that. That's why divorce is so terrible. And if you've been through it, I ain't fussing at you. Can't help it. It's done over with. But you know what? When there's a divorce, the devil gets a foot in the door right there. He gets a foot in the door. All right? Everybody going to be sweet? We're going to do what we're supposed to and be nice to our teacher. Take them an apple. It's got a worm in it. They don't do that no more, do they? Take a teacher an apple. Them kids don't know what an apple is. Take them a gummy bear. Or a Skittle or something, I reckon. All right. It's getting late now and you got to go to bed from now on. Early. As soon as it gets dark. That's terrible. Isn't it? You ask my girls right over there what time they had to go to bed. What time? No, not right. Whenever they wanted to. I said, I don't care what time you go to bed, but you're going to get up in the morning when you're supposed to. Then the next night, they'd go to bed a little bit earlier, a little bit earlier. We made it somehow by the grace of God. All right, we're going to pray. I want every one of y'all. Now look, watch this, kids. How many of y'all will pray for them? Raise your hand if you'll pray for them. Look at that. You got all them people praying for you. So if you mess up, y'all be ashamed of yourself. I mean, good night. You got a good church. You got people that love you. And so you stay in there and do right. If you do something wrong, you ask God to forgive you and just keep on. Read your Bible every day. Do right. Them people that school try to get you to do wrong, they ain't so cool. They ain't nothing. They ain't nothing. I don't know who they think they are. We can be 10 times cooler than that if we wanted to. But it ain't cool. All right? Amen. All right. We're going to pray. And then we're going to let you go. Let's all stand, please. Go ahead, brother.
Hey, y'all, remember what we talked about Sunday school? Those of y'all that came in there, don't forget to go by that track rack.
Yeah,
that's
amen.
That's going to make a difference in whether you make it or not, whether you're willing to take a stand. That track rack back here.
Amen.
Y'all came to the altar, but if you go to that track rack, that's where the difference is going to be.
That's right.
Go by there and get some of them things.
He's right. Right back there at the door, there's tracks. Take some tracks to school. And Kelly filled it up yesterday. He was down here for bus meeting. It's full of tracks. Take them and give them out. Don't let them lay around. Amen? All right. All minds and hearts clear. Brother Mike, if you don't mind, why don't you come up here and dismiss us now? Brother Mike is a teacher in our public school. He was a principal. They fired him. And no, they didn't. No, I don't know why. He went back to teaching or something like that. What do you teach, brother?
I'm a science teacher.
He's a science teacher. But he believes the word of God. He's a deacon in our church. So he's going to, you can say something if you want to, the kids, and dismiss us.
Well, I didn't know he was going to do this, so I don't know what I'm going to say, but I know that some of you, when you step in that door tomorrow, the pressure is going to be on even before you get there. Right. From the school bus, even to what you decide to wear tomorrow. Remember to go God's way. It's God's way. The devil's way looks good today, but it ends up in destruction.
Man.
God's way doesn't look so good sometime today, but it ends up in eternal life. And remember that when it's on.
Amen.
And I'll pray for us. Pray for me, too.
Amen.
See what I'm going to. All right. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, thank you, Lord. Thank you for your spirit here tonight. Lord God, thank you, Lord, that we can now put on our armor and step out here into this world, step out here into this battle. And Lord God, know that you'll never leave us or forsake us, Lord, but you're going to be there with us, Lord, in the fight. Lord, protect us from the devil's arrows. Lord, please help our choice to be with you and not with Satan. Lord, help us take a stand tomorrow and every day after. Lord God, knowing that you took a stand on the cross for me and for everybody here. Lord God, help us never be ashamed. Help us live it every day and in every situation. Lord God, give us your power, give us your grace, and give us your mercy. And we'll be looking forward to see you. In Jesus' name, amen.